Andrew Katz. You and I find ourselves at a crossroad, my friend, though you may or may not be aware of it. I've known you for a long time, Andrew. You've been a dear friend of my youngest brother, Jack, for whom I have mixed feelings, as you know. And that means you are not an insignificant player in my life. You are, more accurately, a moderately significant player in my life. On a scale of 0 to 10, 10 being significant and 0 being the last breath I just exhaled, you are about a 5.71. And that's a good score. Well, I'm contacting you because I felt compelled to let you know that the people around town are talking about you. And yes, you may be curious, it is about your birthday. But not what you probably expect.
What the hell?
I know you know where he is!
You don't know nothing!
It is controversial.
You are right, it's the forest! I'm sorry!
Ravens! I summon you!
What can I say about Andrew Katz?
Happy birthday, Andrew. I love you so much. And it's been really great to be going to the same college together.
Can't really be in a room with him for longer than 3 minutes without cracking up at something, some joke that he came up with, you know.
Between you and me, the commissioner used to work at a circus.
Yeah.
I don't know if any of us are really qualified or ready for what we're doing.
Would he have any connection to the clowns?
Kitty Katz is getting older, which is kind of weird, because like he's the body of like a 19-year-old, but like he has the mind of like a 4-year-old.
Andrew has a very large personality.
Andrew has been my best friend since before either of us were born. Our motto's from the womb to the tomb, and we take that very seriously. But the question mainly becomes, who will reach the tomb first?
I have a deep-rooted affection for Andrew. Like, when I first met him, he was just, like, this fat little Jew, and I just felt like, yes, he protect this boy. And then I got to know him, and I was like, oh my god, he's such an asshole.
Shut up, Brad!
Where is she?
Pussy.
Me and Kitty Katz were not originally friends. He was the last one I was really introduced to in, like, this group, when Jack so kindly brought me into the group in sixth grade, instead of earlier on, when he had the chance after baseball, but we don't need to get into that right now.
Andrew is a good guy. Deep down. Deep. Deep, deep down. Like, very deep. Like, journey to the center of the earth deep.
I'm pretty sure we could never get through a scene of anything without him bringing up the clown.
Once you got the door, it was a clown.
I still don't really understand what that is, and I don't think I really want to, but I know that every single time he would mention a clown, we would just die laughing. And I'm like, I don't even know. I feel like anybody else would have said that, and I wouldn't find it funny, but since it was Andrew Katz, I found it funny.
I must say, for me personally, it was one of the hardest actors to work with, because I couldn't have a hard enough time keeping a straight face during any films in general. And then you throw Andrew into the mix, and you know, I'm cracking up on every scene, and we're redoing scenes 100 times because of me.
I have definitely never seen anybody with his sense of humor before.
No.
He's one of those people who makes you laugh at yourself. Like, everyone. He'll say something really, really mean, but then I find myself laughing at it anyway. It's kind of like this weird hypnosis thing he has going on, like a mind control. And I kind of think he might be a wizard. But I don't know.
I really do miss Andrew since we've been at college. It's been weird being away from everyone for so long, you know, you make whole new groups of friends, then it's like, I don't know, it's weird missing everyone, but.
He's always been such a great actor, and he always puts everything into his characters and really goes for it.
He's just a really funny guy, and he has, like, perfect comedic timing.
Now that your husband's dead, who's gonna pay for his
coffin and funeral at a graveyard.
Watching him, Jack, and Ryan work together in an improv situation, like on just anything they're in together, is incredible, because I know that I could never do something like that. There's just the way they play off of each other, and like the quick wit that they all have is awesome. It's awesome to watch. And a lot of times when we film them, you don't realize it's improv. You know, I was like, oh, when did you write that? And they'd be like, what are you talking about? We just did that right now. We just set up a situation and that's what we did. And I was like, oh my God.
Okay, no. That was a pitiful kiss. Disgusting.
Like, me and him, like, we have more of, like, a bro-ish kind of, like, relationship. And that's not a bad thing. Because I don't really, like, have that with a guy.
He is really inspiring to watch as an actor.
I want to be the good cop, but at the same time, I also want to beat the shit out of you.
You don't need to do it!
His parts are always really funny or very serious, and he's very good at that, so.
How much meaner can you get to me? But crazy. Well, I guess we kind of all have to be to play the game.
Andrew is a great actor in the fact that he can be extremely hilarious by just dropping the craziest one-liners that no one other than him could think of.
Where's Tim?
I'm Tim now.
And also being an incredible dramatical and character actor. In Corruption, he has done some incredible stuff.
My name right,
and I'm Ted.
No!
It's your birthday. You know, you feel pretty good, don't you? Don't you? Oh, you do. I know you do, Andrew. I know you very well. You feel fucking good right now.
I have to say, I'm probably a little bit biased in saying this, but I think his best character is Dom from Average Day/Average Night. It's like, I think it just epitomizes Andrew, like this big, like tough, like guy in charge, when really he's just got like the softest insides and underbelly.
You look lovely today.
Oh, thank you.
I was kidding.
Hey, you can go down that staircase.
I'm doing it anyway.
Andrew is one of the most important people in my life. He is finally 19, even though I achieved that 3 months before he did. And he broke the stick of friendship like a monster.
Katz, I love you, man. I know so many great things are ahead of you because you are so smart and you know a random array of shit that no one needs to know, but you do know. But I don't know. I miss you, man. I love you. I'm glad you're home. I'm glad we're home on summer right now. We can see each other and hang out. Happy birthday, man. Love you.
He's gonna do great things in his life, and I'm so excited to see where he goes, because it's gonna be great.
Happy birthday, Andrew. Hope you have a good one. I'll see you soon.
Andrew, you're actually such a good friend to me, and I love you so much. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Andrew.
Well, happy birthday. Hope your day is good, just like you.
Love you, man. Happy birthday.
You celebrate your birthday. You have the birthdayiest of birthdays. You just rock that with the vigor only a Katz possesses. And trust me, I know. Your brother was a good friend of mine. So, I pretty much said everything I have to say. Now get out of my face. I'm done. This was ridiculously long.